We will also need a plunger, and we will need pipettes. Okay, these pipettes are 1 mL pipettes. Notice how that these 1 mL pipettes go up and end at a zero line. The zero line indicates that if you draw liquid up to that line, 1 mL is present in that pipette. These gradations are 0.1 mil. When we use our pipettes, we want to do the very best we can not to touch them on the bottoms, but make sure that we hold them and touch them on the tops, because we want to keep them as clean and as aseptic as possible. So they shouldn't be sitting on the bench. We should always be trying to hold them and keep them away from any possible contamination. We've got our plunger. We're going to insert that pipette into the plunger. Before we go any further, notice how when I insert that pipette, it's pretty tight. Make sure you get a nice snug fit, otherwise you won't draw up as much liquid as you desire. Also, notice that there's a cotton swab in here. That cotton swab is designed to prevent you from drawing up too much liquid into the plunger itself. We want to make sure that whenever we're using our pipettes and we're planning on putting them into a solution of bacteria, for example, that we don't let that pipette touch the table, because that's gonna throw off our counts, and we wanna be as accurate as possible. We've got our stock solution. We wanna make sure we shake that up nice and well. Be careful, sometimes the lids don't stay on real tight. You wanna make sure you shake away from your face. Okay? We don't want any potential bacteria getting near your face. And we've got our finger on the lid as we're shaking. Give it a nice, about 25 shakes is enough. We'll take the lid off. And remembering our proper aseptic technique, we want to make sure that that lid doesn't touch the benchtop. Okay? We then take our pipette and dip it into our liquid, and we are going to be delivering 1 mL into our first test tube. So once again, we draw up to that zero line. We'll set that stock vial on the benchtop. We'll cap that up, make sure nothing falls in, being as aseptic as possible. Then we'll open up our 10 to the negative 1 dilution vial, or whatever vial is present in your lab manual. We very carefully open up that test tube and dispense by either pushing the plunger down on the top or rolling our plunger. And as you can see, we dispense that liquid into our vial. Notice how my cotton swab is still there. It's not colored at all, meaning that I didn't drop too far. I'm going to cap up my test tube, and then I'm going to properly dispose my pipette tip, or my pipette, into the biohazard bin.